有些在西方的一些藏传佛教的这个中心里面有这个三年的闭关三年的闭关，我在尼玛巴的一些闭关中心当中呢也看到了有人闭关三年然后呢嘎举牌的这个这个中心里面呢也有这闭关三年的，那这些都是非常好的但是如果这个三年的这个时间当中只是念个咒念一念本尊的咒把这个数量作为一个标准的话，那这个意义并不大那真正要这个修要闭关的话，那在这个三年的时间当中我们从零开始，从人生难得开始把四加心全部修完，然后就是培养自己的这个出离心然后就把这个从皈依开始五个加心一个一个的修，然后呢忏悔积累资粮等等全部就是在这个三年的过程当中是可以完成的修一个一边这样子非常标准的这个加心，那是非常有意思。如果闭关修心的话，基本上是这些加心是两年之内是可以修完的，两年之内修完，然后两年修完了以后呢，然后第三年再修其他的第三个加心第三个加心，或者是修大圆满大寿因，那这样子确实是这个三年的时间确实是我们的人生当中可以说是最有意义的最有意义的时间。
In the West, at some Tibetan Buddhist centers, I have heard about three-year retreat programs that exist in Nyingma centers as well as at Kagyu centers as well. And these are all very good. However, if during these 3 years of retreat, retreatments only use this time to accumulate Idam mantras, only to accumulate a particular quantity or number of mantra recitations, then this isn't such a meaningful way to spend the time. So what we really need to do is start from zero, beginning from basics with contemplating the preciousness and rareness of a human rebirth, cultivating renunciation, then moving on to taking refuge, confessing wrongdoings, accumulating merit, one by one, completing each exercise in the preliminary practices to a very good level. And if we were to spend our time in retreat completing the preliminary practices in a proper and diligent way, then this would be an extremely meaningful way to spend this time in retreat. So to complete the preliminary practices in a retreat environment would probably take about 2 years. And if we did this, then the third year could be used completing a final preliminary practice or otherwise moving on to the Great Perfection or Mahamudra practice. If we were to conduct or carry out our retreat in this way, then it would no doubt be the most meaningful period of our whole lives.
然后这个这个如果我们没有那么多的时间闭关修行的话，那就我们这个每一天都有一个这么一个小时或者两个小时这样子的时间当中打坐修行，尽量的坚持，然后星期六或者星期天的时候呢多安排一些时间来修加心还有每年的这些公共假期，还有这个这些时候呢 休假的时候呢，这些稍微比较有时间的时候啊，然后就到一个寺庙或者是其他比较安静的地方，像闭关中心啊这类的地方去闭关啊，比如说5天、10天、半个月这样的时间去修的话，也虽然时间有点长，但是呢也可以完成啊。我们比如说没有条件去闭关3年，那这样子的话呢，就是这个边工作边修四加性和五加性也是可以的，只不过时间可能这个进步可能稍微慢一点啊，进度稍微慢一点啊，但实际上是可以完成的。
So if we don't have so much time to go on retreat and engage in practice in this kind of format, then we can still allocate 1 or 2 hours every day to our completion of the preliminary practices and do our best to persevere with this level of practice. In addition to this, on the weekends, on Saturday and Sunday, we can dedicate more time to completing the preliminaries and also make the most of our public holidays as well. When we have a bit of extra time, we can go to a monastery or to a retreat center and perhaps spend 5 or 10 days or half a month working on the preliminary practices too. So even though this will take us a longer time than if we were to complete the preliminary practices in a retreat context, it's still possible very much for us to finish them, to complete them. So if we are not able to take part in a 3-year retreat situation, then it is very much possible for us to combine the preliminary practices with our everyday work and life commitments. It's only that our progress will be a little bit slower than if we were to do it in a retreat setting.